Hello, this is Robert, and in this video I would like to discuss how to work with text files using Xcode. If we take a look at our program right here, I have three libraries loaded: fstream, iostream, and string. And the fstream library gives me access to ifstreams and ofstreams. The ifstream object is so that we can open files for reading, and then ofstream is for writing. So I have two variables set up. One's called infile and the other one is called outfile, and I can choose any name that I want for those. These are variable names. So if I'd like to call it input file, I can do that. So it's up to me what I name my variables. And then I have a string, which is where I'm going to store the file name. And then I have a line, and I'm just going to store the first line from the input file using that string variable right there. So then I prompt for the file name, and then I'm going to input the file name right there just using standard C in extraction. Then I'm going to open the file name. Then I'm going to use getLine to read the full line from the file, the very first full line. Notice that I can use getLine or I can use extraction or whatever I want with an input file. Let's say I only wanted the first word from the file, then instead of getLine, I would just use regular extraction. So infile line, like that. Anything I can do with cin, I can do with an input file, because they're both input file streams. Okay. So after that, I'm just going to announce what the first line from the file is. And then I'm going to ask the user what they would like to call the output file. And I'm done using file names for the input file right there. So I'm just going to reuse that variable file name for the output file. And once the output file is open on line 21 right there, I'm just going to write the first line from the input file to the output file. And notice I'm just using insertion. So anything that I can do with cout, I can also do with an ofstream object. So I'm just using insertion with outfile right there to write the first line and then a new line character at the end. And then it's important to make sure and close your files when you're done with them. Okay, let's switch gears now and take a look at how we can use Textedit in order to manipulate files. Textedit works a little bit differently than other text programs that you might have used. So let's go ahead and open up this greeting.txt file that I have. And so it's open, you can see that it's open in Textedit right there. And the only thing in the file is hello, how are you? Textedit has two formats, or two modes, I guess you could say. One is rich text format and the other is plain text. This text file is in plain text, but if I would like to view it as rich text format, I can select format and then make rich text. Okay, notice that the rulers popped up right there. And so that's your indication that we are in rich text format. And notice that I can select different fonts. I can select the font size, etc. So this is the wrong format for what we want to do. When you first open Textedit and when you create a new document, it will be in rich text format. So here's a brand new one that I just created, and it is in rich text format. Well, it's going to contain a lot of text that won't make any sense when we open it in our C++ program. So what we have to do is we have to change the format to plain text. And the shortcut is Command Shift T. So I'm in rich text format now. I don't want that format, so I hold down the Command key and the Shift key, and then I type a T. And now I'm back to plain text, which is what we want. All right. One of the other interesting things about Textedit is that you don't have to save your changes. And so it's a little strange at first. But let me make a change to this file. Have a nice day. And then if I just quit the program, it doesn't tell me that it saved, but in actuality, it actually did save it. So let's go ahead and open up greeting.txt again. And even though I didn't click save, it actually saved my edits for me. So that takes a little bit of getting used to, but that's the way Textedit works. All right, so I'm going to close Textedit one more time. And this greeting.txt is actually on my desktop. I'm going to leave it there for now because I'm going to show you a trick that you can use to open up a text file anywhere you want, and you don't have to type in the directory information. You don't have to type in the path information. You can copy it from the text file itself. So let's start up this program. And it's going to prompt me to input the file name. Okay, well, it's on the desktop. So if I wanted to, I could type in, you know, user or home or whatever the directory is, and then my name, etc. I could do all of that by hand, but there's a much easier way to do it. And the way to do it is to hold down the Option key when you right-click on a file. And if you hold down the Option key when you right-click, you can see down here that it says copy greeting text as path name. I'm going to let go of the Option key, and it reverts back to copy greeting.txt. Well, I want to have the full path, so I'm going to hold down the Option key again, and then I'm going to left-click on that. And then I'm going to go back to my program, and I'm going to just paste it in right there. So that's how I can easily get the path name for an input file that's not in the working directory. And I'll show you where the working directory is in just a moment. Okay, now it's asking me, what would I like to call the output file? Let's just use output.txt. And when I do that, this file will actually be created in the working directory. Let's go to the working directory first so that we can see what's there now. The easiest way to go to the working directory on Xcode is to right-click on the executable program inside of the products directory. Your program has to be compiled first in order for that file to be there, this executable file. So you'll have to click build, or you'll have to run the program in order to have the executable there. But once you've compiled your program and the program is created, just right-click on it and then select Show in Finder. And so this is the working directory. And we can see that here's the executable file right there. And there's nothing else except for some leftover files that I put inside of that text files folder right there. So we can ignore that. So basically, there's nothing else inside of the working directory. Well, let's go back to the program, and then I'll go ahead and type return after output.txt. And let's take a look at what the code said to do. The code said that after we opened the file using file name, we would write the line to out file. So the first line was written to the output file, which I named output.txt right there. Then I closed the input file, and then I closed the output file. So now if we go back to the working directory, we can see that output.txt was created. One of the other interesting things about macOS is that you can select a file, and then you can push the space bar to get a preview of what's inside of the text file. So I just pushed the space bar there in order to see what was inside of the text file. And we can see that hello, how are you was written to output.txt. So our program created that text file for us. Okay. Well, let's say we would just like to be able to specify the file name on the command line right here inside of Xcode without all of the directory information. Well, all we have to do is right-click on it, on the executable, show in the Finder, and then I'm going to drag greeting.txt into that folder right there. So now greeting.txt is inside of the same directory or same folder as student assignments. I'm just going to control click. I'm going to hold down the control key and then left click on debug, and then I get to see the path information, and you can see that the debug folder is buried deep inside of a lot of other folders. So it's much easier to get to the debug folder by just clicking, right clicking on the executable and say show in Finder, and we can go right to the proper folder right there. Now that greeting.txt is in the proper location, I can just type it in as the file name that I would like to open. So greeting.txt, and so the first line from the file is hello, how are you? And then I can choose any other file name that I want. I think I chose output.txt. And so if you overwrite a text file with a brand new text file, all of the data in the previous text file will be overwritten. Okay, so I'm just going to type return. We'll go back to the working directory, and we can see that output.txt is there. Okay, so it was overwritten, but it was just overwritten with the same data. Okay, so that is how to work with text files using Xcode.